on my heart, it's on my mind. Lord, you see everything, all the unsaid things, even what I don't know myself, even what I haven't realized. See it all, see it all, you know it all. I lay it all down. spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in. So, so kind to me. Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so, so good. Shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. stone wall you won't kick down, a lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. Subject yourself to suffering, to rejection, as you knew I would hurt you, still. subject yourself. For the sake of love. press into pain, press into the discomfort, knowing you're found there, knowing you dwell there, knowing I'm not alone. I'm gonna press into these ashes, 'cause they're not a part of me. Come and teach me who I'm meant to be. Break the darkness, this familiarity. I trade it in for glory yet unseen. These ashes, 'cause they're not a part of me. Come and teach me who I'm meant to be. Break the darkness, this familiarity. I trade it in for glory yet unseen. I surrender my rights, surrender my will. Have your way in me, have your way in me. I surrender my rights, surrender my will. Have your way in me. these ashes, 'cause they're not a part of me. Come and teach me who I'm meant to be. Break the darkness, this familiarity. I traded it for glory and a sea. 'Cause I surrender my rights, surrender my will. Have your way in me, have your way in me. I surrender my rights, surrender. Believes in a God that's bigger, in a God that's higher, in a God that knows what he's doing. You know what you're doing. God that's bigger, a God that's higher. He knows what he's doing. You know what you're doing. I'm not gonna question anymore. Oh, doubt anymore. In your bigness, in your goodness. I know I can trust. I know I can trust. Doesn't make sense. I will trust. I surrender my rights.
just thank you that our strength doesn't come from within us. It doesn't come from our bodies themselves. But God, our strength comes from you. We pray tonight that as we pray, as we intercede, God, that you would fill us, that you'd speak through me, speak through each of us, God, as we go through and begin to pray for North Korea, God. This is not something that we can muster up on our own, but we need you for it. And so we ask and we call on you tonight, God. Amen. Yeah, tonight we're going to be interceding on behalf of North Korea through the passage of Romans chapter 8, verses 18 through 27. So I want to ask you guys to all open with me there to Romans 8, because we believe that the Word of God is powerful, and that as we pray, you know, we're shifting the atmosphere, not just here in this room, but actually shifting the atmosphere in North Korea, which we will be praying for. So again, the passage is Romans 8, verses 18 through 27. And yeah, as I lead us in prayer, ask that you guys come in agreement with our prayers for North Korea. So verse 18 says, "For I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory that is to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the sons of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not willingly, but because of him who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself would be set free from its bondage to corruption and obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God." Lord, right now we pray for our brothers and sisters in North Korea, many of whom are suffering things that we cannot relate to, that we can't fully comprehend. God, they're truly suffering. God, they have to worship you in hiding. They don't have the freedom to express themselves fully. Many have been imprisoned, have been placed in internment camps, forced to do manual labor, forced to go through unbearable circumstances for their belief in you. And for many of them, we imagine that it would be easy to just give up, to give in to the hopelessness that weighs so heavily around them, the hopelessness that many of their friends and family have already given in to. There are those who would rather just leave this life than to continue in this kind of situation. But God, there is a glory coming. There's a glory that's incredible, that's magnificent. A glory that's coming soon and very soon. And yeah, that glory is your second coming, your return to this earth, Jesus. But God, you tell us that the glory is also in the revelation of your sons. And that's not a glory that we have to wait who knows how long for, but this is a glory that we can see here and now. And so God, we ask that you would reveal the glory of your sons and daughters in North Korea. That they would be like a city on a hill that cannot be hidden. And God, that their light would shine for all to see. That in their actions, in their words, in the way that they interact with the world around them, that they would reveal that there's a Savior who's living inside of them. That there's something higher that they're looking to, something greater that they're hoping for. And God, that the people of this land would begin to experience freedom. That they would begin to experience and interact with men and women who are truly free. And that they would be drawn to it. God, we come against any fear that is holding your sons and daughters back. We want to see them fully revealed, God. We know that you can do it. We know that you can do it, God. And know that it's in them to reveal Christ in their lives, in the things that they do, in the way that they speak, in the way that they treat and love one another.
Let hope arise.
Verse 22, for we know that the whole creation has been groaning together in the pains of childbirth until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly as we wait eagerly for adoption as sons, the redemption of our bodies. God, it pains us to see right now the state that North Korea is in. God, there's a groaning in us, a pain in us that we can't express, God, that we can't express fully, the injustice that we feel, the fear that we feel, the things that just attempt to overwhelm us, God. God, we pray that as the first fruits, the first carriers of your Spirit in this earth, God, that your sons and daughters would be able to boldly live their lives, God. That their lives would be filled with your Spirit. That their lives would be expressions of their obedience to you, God. And this is a process that takes time. It's taken until now. God, the birth pains of persecution and resistance have continued until now. The resistance to this gospel in North Korea. But God, we long for your children to be revealed. On the way, God. in the works, God. That as a woman goes into labor, we know that it's coming. We know that that baby's coming, God. We know that that bundle of joy is coming. And so we see the circumstances and we recognize that they are not the end, but they are just the beginning. They are not the end, but they are pointing to something greater, to something more. God, you're working in North Korea a pure and spotless bride, a church that is powerful and anointed. You're working in North Korea men and women of character, of hope, of faith, God. Men and women who have power in them. You're working it in them. But God, right now we want to pray through these birth pains. God, that you would strengthen your church to endure. That even if the birth pains get greater, even if the pains get stronger, we know, again, it's not the end, but it's just the beginning, and that the time is coming closer. And so, God, we pray once again for your sons and daughters to be revealed in the fullness of who they are. That outside of the circumstances, they would be seen, God. In the midst of these circumstances, may their light shine even brighter, God. It's just the beginning. God, there's a greater glory yet to come. So we hold on to that, God. We hold on to that, God. With eager expectation, we hope in that, God. For that day of redemption for North Korea, God.
Together.
That is seen is not hope, for who hopes for what he sees? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. God, we have a desire to hear the testimonies of our brothers and sisters in North Korea. But God, right now we speak over them that they would have the testimony of Daniel. That just as Daniel faced punishment for his worship under King Nebuchadnezzar, that the North Koreans face a similar situation. But God, I pray that their testimony would be the same, that even though their worship is illegal, it's restricted, that they would not cease from giving you praise, that they would not cease from proclaiming your name, that they would not cease from confessing you as Savior. Because their hope is not found in what man can do and what this their flesh holds, God, but their hope is found in you. And so, God, we declare that their testimonies will be ones of trust in you, of full, complete trust in you, that as they obey, as they worship, they would believe that you can provide for them, that you can protect them. God, even if they're thrown into the lion's den, may they have the hope that you would protect them from the jaws of the lion. That they would come out unscathed, untouched, unhindered in their spirit, God. That they would be able to have that kind of testimony. This testimony of having never for a second given up hope, but completely trusting in you for their protection, for their safety, for their provision, for everything that they need, God. God, it may seem at times that there's no way to escape, but God, in you, they are untouchable. That there is nothing that can hurt them. And so, God, we pray that their lives would be this kind of life, and that their lives would be a fragrant offering to you, God. We pray for this kind of boldness in believers in North Korea, that they would have the testimony of Daniel.
They will sing no matter how long it takes. call things into being as if they were.
Yeah. Yeah.
Things that are not as though they were. They're gonna call it in faith. They're gonna call it in faith. They're gonna claim their freedom and faith. You'll return in faith. It will be bold for your name, bold for your sake. It will be bold for your name. It will be bold for your sake. It will be bold for your name. It will be bold for your sake.
Out of love.
It's all in love. A response in love. Out of the overflow, they'll sing. Out of the overflow, they'll sing. Sing, sing. Out of the overflow, they'll sing. Out of the overflow, they'll sing.
Fill them up, God.
It's 'cause of love. Response in love.
Fill them up with joy.
A response in love.
Fill them up with joy.
Nothing else can move them. Nothing else can move them. Nothing else can move them but your love. 'Cause nothing else can move them. Nothing else can move. Nothing else can move them but your love. There's nothing else can move them. Nothing else can move them. Nothing else can move them but your love. Hope is rising. Oh,
helps us in our weakness. For we do not know what to pray for as we ought. But the Spirit Himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. God, we thank you that you're speaking through us right now. That you're speaking through us these things that we couldn't express on our own. And God, especially when it comes to hope, it's so hard for us to hope in the things that are unseen, God. We're so prone to focus on the things that we do see. The current sufferings, the current circumstances, or what we could see in the future in our predictions and in our forecasts. God, we see only we focus so much on those things. It's so hard for us to imagine a peaceful situation in North Korea. But God, we know that your ways are higher, that your thoughts are inscrutable, that you work beyond the ways that we understand. And so God, I just pray that you would continue to help us to pray for North Korea, but also continue to help those in North Korea pray for their land. God, we know that our intercession is powerful, but it's so much more powerful when your people living in that land pray for their land, God. It's so powerful. And so we ask, God, that you would speak through them. God, that you would give them the ability to pray through your Spirit, by your Spirit. In groans that are too deep for words. God, strengthen the church in North Korea. Strengthen them in their weakness, God. In their lack of knowledge and in their lack of ability, in their lack of being able to see what they can do to change their country. We pray, God, that you would intercede through them. God, that you would give them your Spirit and fill them. And that out of the overflow, yes, that they would worship you. But also out of the overflow that they would begin to intercede on behalf of their land. God, that they would speak hope over their land. That they would speak life over their land. That they would love their land from the bottom of their hearts, God. That they would have your heart for North Korea. We strengthen our brothers and sisters in North Korea. We speak over them, God. That they are strong in you. That they can do anything in you, God. So, God, we pray. Help them. Holy Spirit, help them.
Overflow, permeate.
I'll be entering into the part of tonight's watch where we'll be praying through various topics for the nation of North Korea. And again, as I pray, I ask that you guys come into agreement with my prayer, and afterwards we'll all begin to pray through these topics on our own. Yeah, God, we just pray for wisdom and peace between North Korea and the United States right now. There's a very interesting situation happening via Twitter. And God, it's causing a lot of fear. It's causing a lot of tension. It's causing a lot of bitterness and distress. And God, we just pray. We declare over these two nations wisdom and peace. We declare that there will be no more escalation in these verbal attacks, that there will be a diffusal of all of the posturing and provoking, God. We declare that, yeah, any attempts to try to, yeah, just display strength, displace superiority would be put to an end, God. We disallow also any violence from proceeding from these events. God, any war from breaking out. We don't want to see any innocents dying. We don't want to see any soldiers dying. We don't want to see an unnecessary war breaking out. God, we declare that there would be a peaceful resolution to this conflict. God, that you would speak to the people surrounding both of these leaders, both Kim Jong-un and Donald Trump, that you would speak and speak words of wisdom through them, God. We know that you speak through anyone, God, that you speak through and give your words of wisdom to everyone. And so we pray, God, that you would speak to these leaders and lead this situation to a peaceful resolution. God, we also pray that, yeah, that somehow that you would use even these actions, God, even these things that seem so divisive and seem so abrasive, that somehow, God, that you'd work them all towards reunification, God. We know that you can do it. We've seen you do it before, God. And we pray this over North Korea and the relationship they have with the United States. Let's pray. God, I pray, we pray that you would expose the hidden roots in North Korea. God, these things that we don't see that are causing this situation to continue to develop, continue to escalate, continue to go on and live on. God, we pray that we would be, that you would expose the roots behind all of this, God. That you'd bring the darkness to light. God, we pray that the world would see the evil in North Korea for what it is. That there would not be a single thing hidden. That there would not be a covering up, God. But Lord, that the world would be able to see this and be able to pray into it and hope into it and act upon it. And God, we pray that the saints would have insight from your Holy Spirit to be able to intercede on behalf of North Korea. We pray, God, that you would reveal it to your sons and daughters, that you would reveal it to your chosen ones, and that they would be able to pray and declare and in the spirit what realm combat the evils that are still lurking in North Korea. God, in the spiritual realm, we pray, God, that you would give your saints insight. And we declare, God, that no plan of the enemy will prosper. That as these things are exposed, that the plans of the enemy would come to an end. That as these things are brought to light, that we would be able to foil them in the spirit. God, you're already doing it, even with this situation between the United States and North Korea. You're bringing to light roots of inferiority, roots of insecurity. You're already bringing these things to light, God. And we just pray that you would continue to do so by your Spirit. Let's pray. Sons and daughters to be revealed. God, that evangelism would grow in North Korea. God, we pray that the believers in North Korea would radiate your glory in their daily lives. God, that everyone around them would look at them and know that there's something different. That they would see them and know that there's something that they have that is giving them this joy, this hope. God, we speak boldness over the believers in North Korea to love others selflessly, to love others vulnerably, to love others in a way that is at cost to their own comfort, at cost to their own safety. God, we pray that they would have boldness to proclaim the gospel and wisdom to lead others to you in discreet but meaningful ways, God, in ways that are loving towards these men and women. God, in ways that are not overtly causing division. But God, I pray that there would be a way to lead others to you. God, that evangelism would become easy to these men and women. God, that they would have the wisdom and the spirit power that they need to do it. God, we pray this, knowing that you're already working in them. But God, we pray for a strengthening of the evangelism movement in North Korea. Let's pray. Pray for all of the North Korean refugees who have already come to South Korea. We want to pray and support them and pray that they find a true home here. God, we pray for their circumstances. We pray that they would have amazing houses and good neighborhoods. We pray that they would be able to be comfortable here in this land. We pray for their work, that they would find work that they can enjoy, but also that pays well and provides for them and their families, God. We pray that they would find community, that they would find people to love them and support them in all that they do, people who could show them the love of Christ. And God, we pray especially for churches and communities and organizations that are open to receive these men and women, these refugees. God, that they would receive them not for anything, God, that they could earn or gain from it, but that they would receive these refugees for who they are, that they would be able to receive them as fellow brothers and sisters, that they would be able to receive them not as different people, not even as refugees, but purely as people to be worthy of love, God. We pray for these refugees, God, that they would have this kind of home, that they would find this kind of comfort, that they would find this kind of love here in South Korea, that they would not be shunned or neglected, that they would not be turned away. But God, we pray for full acceptance of these North Korean refugees. Soften the hearts of the people here in this nation towards them. Soften the hearts of this of South Koreans towards them. God, that they would be able to find that they are home here. That they are no different here, God. Let's pray. That you would reveal yourself to your children. That you would reveal yourself to your children. That they would see how beautiful you are, how loving you are, how great you are, how faithful you are to protect them, to provide for them, to be with them in the midst of their trials, in the midst of their persecution. And God, as they come to see you in greater glory, may they reflect your glory even greater. God, we just thank you for this time where we are able to come in alignment with your heart for North Korea. Pray, God, that you would do all that we've prayed and do all that you've said you would do in North Korea. Yeah, we pray this in your name.